There's a concept around latex printing that I want to discuss because I'm going to use it over and over again in all of these videos. I'm going to keep repeating a mantra. It's the core three pillars of how to print successfully with all latex printers, no matter the industrial latex all the way down to the smallest one. And it is speed, temperature, ink load. Speed, temperature, ink load, that is the balance for all successful latex printing. I'm going to mention it in a lot of different contexts because the more you understand the idea, when you adjust speed, you adjust temperature, you adjust ink load, they have to be in a harmony with one another, a balance. And that equilibrium, that's the perfect latex print. Because if you have those balanced out, you're going to be successful no matter what media you put on the printer. As a general rule, I can print on almost anything on a 3-inch core. There's not much I can't print on. But each material has its own unique temperature. It has its own unique speed as a result of that temperature. And then it has its own ink load signature as a basis from that temperature. And all medias react differently to temperature. So if you understand that relationship, you can apply it in every case and be successful. So I wanted to introduce the concept because I'm going to go over it quite a bit. Speed is passes. Simple as that. For this particular 360, 4-pass for me is as fast as I run. 2-pass has some very limited value, but for the most part, I start at 4-pass. 4-pass on a 360 with things like certain scrim banners, and that is a viable print speed. That is the fastest the printer goes, 4-pass. As you go to 6-pass and 8-pass and 10-pass, what's happening is your speed is slowing down a little bit. It gets a little slower with every pass mode. Now the printer is 1200 DPI, 12 picoliter drop, all pass modes, which is fantastic. It means you're not changing resolutions as you're changing speed. The speed is one variable to successful latex printing. The second is temperature. Every media has a thermal signature. Some medias, even though they're heavy, might have a very low thermal signature. You know, for example, at 185 degrees, synthetic paper starts to warp. So you have to keep the temperature below that thermal deformation point or it's never going to be successful. So everything you do has to revolve around, say, 175 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, if that's true, you're going to have to adjust your speed correspondingly. The speed then is going to be slower. Your dwell time is increased to compensate for this temperature-sensitive media. And then if you know your speed, or excuse me, if you know your temperature, and then you're mostly guessing your speed, let's say 16-pass, now all that remains is how much ink can you put down. You can't change the temperature. The media will only take so much. Now, some medias will take almost unlimited amounts of temperature, like certain scrim banners or fabrics. Certainly a lot more temperature than this printer can deliver. This printer tops out at 241 degrees Fahrenheit. But some medias, you can run, and you can run them very successfully, but you have to keep that temperature down to do it. And if the temperature is lower, generally, you're going to have a slower pass mode, or say 12-pass, and then you're going to put as much ink as you can put down with those two known variables. It's really simple. And the printer is designed to walk you through that speed temperature ink load in the easiest way of any printer that's ever been manufactured. We have a simple and elegant way. I have a video on it. It goes through the steps, and the first step, your very first step, is a calibration chart that determines at this temperature, at this speed, how much ink can you put down. It's elegant, it's easy. We're going to go over it next. I'll show it to you. I'll explain what the different points mean, and you can do it on all of the latex printers. So that is speed, temperature, and ink load. Again and again, I'm going to refer to it. The more you understand it, the better you'll understand how to print on latex printers, and then you'll be able to print on just about anything on a 3-inch core.